It is now time for the 1998 Royal Rumble.
Here we go.
Here are the rules.
In a moment, numbers 1 and 2 will enter the ring. And every 2 minutes thereafter, another superstar will enter according to the number they drew. When a superstar's feet hits the floor, they are eliminated from the match. This only occurs if both feet hit the floor. The final surviving man left in the ring when all 30 participants have entered will be declared the winner and will not only move on to WrestleMania to fight Yokozuna, but will determine the draft order for the 2020 Galope League season. And now, let us all find out who drew number one for the Royal Rumble. Hulk Hogan? Hogan drew number one? This can't be real wrestling. My God, Hogan doesn't job the number one. The only question that could be is, who can he go coast to coast without dying? Who knows? Who knows? This is obviously a very, very problematic situation for Joe, who has Hogan as his entrant, as the Hulkster takes about 4 days to get into the ring. And now, let us all find out who drew number two! Kyle. Kyle's in deep trouble too now. Wow! How did this happen? It's clearly a battle of the old guard versus the, well, current old guard between Jericho and Hogan here. This is gonna be epic. And we're underway. The Rumble has begun with Hogan and Jericho trading off blows. Kicks to the face, kicks to the midsection. Hogan with a grapple. He's already sending Jericho to the ropes. Once again, he's sending Jericho to the other end of the rope. He didn't like that. Oh, and a beautiful Samoan drop. Kick to the stomach. Hogan keeping the offense going. Clearly, he's going to sprint, but Jericho just too young, too fast. As number three comes in. Oh, my God. It's The Rock. The Rock. Dwayne The Rock Johnson. Another player pick wrestler. This one going to Eric. So right now we have Eric, Kyle, and Joe already in the ring early often. They got a long way to go ahead of them. Here's number four now. It's William Regal, a computer-owned player, just basically in there to cause chaos and eliminate our guys. So here we go. Eric duking it out with Joe. Joe, oh, almost threw him out now, but Eric counters it. Number five is coming in with Edge. Edge. Yeah, that's all I got for him. Seems to be Joe going back to Kyle. Scoop slam. And Eric wants a little piece of Joe here. Going right after Hogan. Hogan Rock, obviously. WrestleMania 18 reminiscent of Rock's big victory. And there goes William Regal, our first elimination of the Rumble. Number six is Vince McMahon himself. The owner of the WWE. You'd think he would give himself a higher number. I guess not. Kyle, Eric, and Joe already standing tall. There goes Joe! Hulk Hogan's first one knocked out of the Rumble. Joe will not be drafted. Determining the order, thankfully. Here comes Vince McMahon. Vince McMahon is gone too, and now it's down to Kyle and Eric duking it out. And here comes number seven, Goldust, and there goes Kyle. Eric cleaning house right now. Him and Mark Goldust, Mark Straczewski's character selected. Oh, talking, throwing some shade there to Eric. But Eric responds right back with an elbow and a Russian leg sweep. And here comes number nine. Murder, murder, murder. Chris Benoit, our defending champion, unfortunately, of the last Royal Rumble, coming in. And, oh, he's just killing the competition, throwing out Goldust. Rock not having any of his abuse, though. Trying to throw him out. Nope, but no avail. Benoit, oh, and he nails The Rock. And Benoit, like his household, has cleared house. Here comes number seven. Oh, God, Kane. For those who don't know, Kane is Tim's pick to win this. And, yeah, get him, Benoit. I've never rooted for anyone else. All right, good. Benoit. Wow, Dan Gentile's guys cleaning house. It's number seven, Maven, another computer character is coming in. Gentile on a roll here, cleaning house as we. That's the first third of the Rumble already gone through. And oh, Gentile struggling to get back in, but he manages to do so. Comes the next guy is Jeff Hardy. another computer-owned wrestler. Ooh, Gentile, you gotta give the guy credit. I mean, he's back with a vengeance, it seems, and Benoit is playing to win this thing. Computerized Benoit, definitely a force to be reckoned with in these Royal Rumbles. Here comes the next guy out. Oh, it's X-Pac. That's a shame. I forgot I included X-Pac in this thing. Nobody likes X-Pac. No one. All right. So we just got Gentile right now, and the next guy out is Kurt Angle. Currently just a few people eliminated. One, two, three. Give me a few seconds. Gentile going up top. Oh, Benoit with a flying headbutt. That won't leave him concussed at all. And it's Rico. Oh my god, it's Rico. I forgot he existed. That is just... how do you fight in that? Just... Gentile in a bunch of computers, but still standing tall. I mean, hanging in the corner. He's doing his thing. He's surviving. That's what you got to do with these things. Oh, spinning heel kick by Rico, and here comes Booker T is our next entry. He's owned by Ed. And I mean, he was selected by Ed. He wasn't owned. I'm just going to stop it right there. Him and Gentile duking it out, and Ed seems to be getting the advantage right here with Booker. Booker just having his way with Chris Benoit. Uh-oh, Benoit with the counter. Chops to the midsection, club to the back, kick to the back. And Benoit going back up top. He's living up top, this Rumble. Benoit now with another cross arm breaker. Just destroying. Here we go with the double team on X-Pac like they need it. All right, Benoit just hammering and just putting submissions on everybody now. He's got one on X-Pac. Too bad there's no taps in the Rumble. Booker T now going to Rico, hopefully avoiding the wrath that is Chris Benoit. Benoit going after the Anaheim Angel, Kurt Angle. Going with a clothesline. And Benoit now, surprise, surprise, has been able to accumulate a special move. Maybe we'll see a Crippler Crossface later on in the Rumble. That'd be tragic. Booker T trying to throw him out and just gives up. Ed can't be happy with that. Benoit German suplexes him for his troubles. Booker breaks out of it. Tries to go for the elimination. No avail. Here comes Kurt Angle now throwing out X-Pac. Then X-Pac has been eliminated. That was a computerized player, so he's out. And Booker's thrown out too this time, but this time by Angle. So there goes Ed. Another elimination. That brings us down to 10. 10 players left. By my count, could be off, but right now Ed, Joe, Tim, Mark, Kyle, Strazewski, and Eric have all been eliminated. Here comes our next participant at the midway point of the Rumble. Who's it going to be? It looks like... oh, it's Triple H. This one owned by Manny. Manny with Triple H to see what he can do. Goes right after Jeff Hardy, whose career he destroyed in, I want to say, 2012? That sounds about right. Benoit and Angle, classic feud going at it. Anaheim Angel, Kurt Angle, still cannot eliminate Benoit. Benoit is a trooper, man. He's just going to town. He's hung in this thing for at least 30 minutes. Uh-oh, it's Reverend Devon. Uh-oh, Crippler Crossface. Yes, he does. He hits it. Too bad it won't help him eliminate anybody, and there goes Jeff Harvey. Knocked out by Reverend Devon, Reverend. And Kurt Angle just got super kicked by Rico. Eliminated. And there goes Rico by Gentile. Gentile is on a roll, man. It's Manny, Gentile, and Reverend Devon right now in the ring. And there goes. Could Devon hang on? No. Yes, he can. Manny and Gentile still duking it out. Who's next? And it looks like, oh, it's Shawn Michaels. This was owned by Dave and Mike. Shawn standing around chilling right now. Wondering who to attack as he does. I've never seen Shawn Michaels do that kick other than in video games in my entire life. That kick is horrendous. Shawn Michaels now. Oh, it's The Undertaker. This one is now, he's owned by Shawn. And here we go. We got four guys in the ring all owned by a player. We got Shawn with The Undertaker, Manny with Triple H, Dave and Mike with Shawn Michaels, and Gentile with Benoit. Ring's filling up with stars. Here we go. With 10 guys left, who was next? And it's Diamond Dallas Page, another entry. This one owned by your commissioner. So he ain't gonna win. Oh, he's trying to throw out Shawn Michaels. I really wouldn't mind that as much. Oh, someone, did someone go? Yeah, someone just went. I think it was Triple H. Triple H is out. Manny has been eliminated. I kind of missed that. So, sorry, Manny. You're out of the competition. And then there were four again. As another entry comes in, and it looks like, oh, it's Scotty Too Hotty, another entry for the league. This one from Bree and Andy, who I can only imagine took the name because, well, Scotty Too Hotty. There goes, oh, Gentile's gone. Great run by Chris Benoit. Gentile, good run, buddy. Good run. Mike and Dave had other plans, unfortunately. Another elimination. As we now go down to, I believe, 8 players are left. And there goes DDP, Mike. That's 7. The commish is now out. So that leaves 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 players have been eliminated from the Rumble. Big Show now in. He's entered. There, oh, Scotty Too Hotty. Scotty is gone. Big Show owned by Gary. Scotty Too Hotty, Andy and Bree take the showers. The defending champ is out as Chuck comes in. Chucky. And there goes Shawn Michaels by the Big Show. So Dave and Mike won't be selected in the first round. So we are down to, from what I see, 5 players. Big Show struggling to stay in, and Big Show's gone as Billy Gunn enters the ring. So that leaves us down to 4. So it leaves us down to, right now, Shawn is in the ring, is the only one in the ring with The Undertaker. Still to come is Ric Flair, owned by Kyle Coleman, Randy Orton, owned by Nick Lombardi, and Jim, who has Brock Lesnar. So, and there's only 8 guys left in this whole thing, so the luck of the draw really benefiting Lombardi, Kyle, and Jim at this moment as Eddie Guerrero gets destroyed. Wow, Shawn's right now the senior citizen. Here comes the Hurricane. Man! So 3 guys left, and Kyle, Jim, and Lombardi all hit the last, hit 28, 29, and 30. And it must be nice. Hurricane going at it with Eddie Guerrero right now as he struggles, but he puts him back in the ring as Hurricane poses. And here comes Ric Flair now. Kyle hitting the bottom rung of those 3. And there goes. Someone went flying. I want to say it was a Hurricane. Hurricane's gone as Ric Flair just stares at Eddie Guerrero. Uh-oh, Undertaker setting him up for a tombstone. Too bad pinfalls don't count. Shawn trying to make an exhibition out of this. Oh, Ric Flair doesn't have any of that. Kyle having at it with him. Who's number 29? And 29 is Randy Orton. Oh, and it's old school Randy Orton. It's not Legend Killer. Randy, this is old school. Lombardi might be in trouble. This is when Randy was a jobber. He's going right at it with Billy or Chuck. I can't really decide who that is. All right, Shawn and Kyle are going at it. Flair and Undertaker as 2 computers. It's Billy and Eddie Guerrero go at it. Uh-oh. Not a good idea, Rick. Get away from him, Rick. Get away. Oh, and Chuck Palumbo staggers in and almost... Oh, but Billy Gunn makes the save and knocks out Kyle. And we are down to 3. It's Jim, Lombardi, or Shawn. One of these 3 men is picking the divisional... is picking the draft order. It's gonna be tough. You got last year's runner-up, you got the inaugural champion, and you got a former champion in Jim. And here comes number 30, Brock Lesnar, the Beast. Here we go. Your final 6 of the Royal Rumble is here. 3 computer guys, 3 human players. Now, for the basis of the rules, none of the human players win. It's the one who finishes the closest to first place. So, none of those necessarily Undertaker, Orton, or Lesnar need to win this thing to get there. Here we go. Lesnar now going at it with Chuck. Oh! Man, Lesnar is just killing people. Brock just going right at it. Orton and Undertaker. Not a good idea, Randy. Shawn. Shawn's been in there for a while, too, man. Undertaker's been in there, I think, since like 15. Oh, almost had Lombardi eliminated there. Here we go. Lesnar and Guerrero. Oh, a double leg takedown by Lesnar. Just having his way with Eddie. Elimination's got to be coming here soon. Lesnar is just destroying it. Oh, Eddie with a Hurricanrana. And Undertaker now destroying Randy Orton. But it's keeping him in the ring. That's all that matters. Lesnar with a rear naked choke. Going for the submissions, man. I don't get it. Here we go. Oh, and there goes Eddie. That's it. We're down to 3. One of these 3 men is going to determine the draft order. I said that before. And there goes, oh, Jim is out. And that's it. We're down to 2. It's either Lombardi or Shawn. Who's determining the draft order? Undertaker is Shawn. Lombardi is Orton. And Undertaker just going to town. He's got to throw him out, though. That's the thing. You have to be thrown out of the ring to be the winner. Oh, we're in over the top from these. Oh, he gets right back in with a late leg drop. Undertaker just not having any of it. Whipping Orton like he's a government mule. Ooh. Orton, another drop kick. Orton trying to battle back. Oh, but Undertaker's not having any of it. Shawn at ringside, cheering on his man. Lombardi flipping Shawn the bird. Oh, back and forth. Orton with a kick as he just stares him down. Drop kick by Orton. He's got the advantage right now. Can he take advantage of it? With a beautiful sidewalk slam by Randy. Orton trying to be the legend killer a little early on. Undertaker with a boot to the face. Down goes Orton. Flips him over. Throw him out already. Jesus, one of you two, just get on with it. Can Undertaker do it? He's got him. He's got him, but he decides to pose. What are you doing? And Orton taking advantage. He will win it. Oh, my God. Randy Orton. Randy Orton. Good God almighty. Good God. That's it. Lombardi wins the draft game. Lombardi decides who he picks. Who picks where, I should say. Congrats to him.